The concept genre is commonplace in essentially every form of literature, whether it be romance novels or TV sitcoms. And while each genre can usually be found throughout the world, some have a region or nation with which they are typically associated. For example, two films frequently associated with the United States are the Western and the road movie. While the Western dates back nearly to the beginning of cinema in 1903 with the release of The Great Train Robbery, the road movie is a more recent genre, with its birth taking place in the late 60s with films such as Bonnie and Clyde in 1967 and Easy Rider in 1969. While the Western and the road movie are generally considered to be two distinct genres, I will consider their similarities and argue that the road movie is really a recontextualization of the Western that takes the common themes and iconography of the Western and reimagines them in the post-war mentality of the United States. To demonstrate this claim, I will consider Arthur Penn's Bonnie and Clyde, a landmark road movie according to Timothy Corrigan. A careful examination of the film shows how its narrative structure essentially inverts several corresponding elements of the classic Western, specifically regarding gender roles in American society. In many respects, the elements of the road movie's narrative are also found in that of the Western. Both genres at their foundation focus on the journey of the characters rather than the destination. Moreover, the narratives of both genres emphasize a sense of the journey's uncertainty, but it is the very nature of the uncertainty that serves as the key difference between the structures of these two genres. While the Western typically places the uncertainty in the land through which the journey of the protagonist takes place, the road movie places the uncertainty in the purpose of the journey itself. In other words, the Western usually has a journey with a known goal, such as wealth or revenge, through an unknown or uncharted territory, also known as the Wild West. While the road movie has a journey through a known territory, the United States highway system, with an unknown objective. As Stephanie Watson points out, the roads on which the protagonist of the road movie finds him or herself aimlessly roaming are frequently the same roads the cowboy of the Western originally mapped. However, despite the clearly defined nature of the highway system, the ambiguity of the purpose results in what Corrigan suggests is an unfamiliarity of the road system, in essence, making what is technically known and domestic mysterious and foreign. Bonnie and Clyde serves as an excellent example of this aimless wandering. The titular characters of the film find themselves haphazardly traveling from town to town, robbing banks and stealing cars. But they do not set out for this lifestyle only in the pursuit of crime. Rather, their goal is far less tangible than that. As James Ullman and John Heitman contend, Bonnie's relationship with the open road represents both feminine desire and, quote, dreams of autonomy. For Clyde, on the other hand, the motivation is a compulsion to defend his masculinity by defying authority. The desires of both of these characters directly correlate to postwar sentiments in the US as internal conflicts arose regarding the roles of women and men in society. During World War II, many women joined the workforce to fill the jobs left open by the drafted men who went to war. But upon the men's return, most women, understandably, resisted relinquishing their newfound autonomy. Thus, Bonnie's desire for independence has strong ties to the sentiments of many women at the time. As for Clyde's connection to the male post-war perspective, with no more good wars to fight and less of a clear need for men to be breadwinners, many men were left not knowing their purpose in society. Moreover, a defining characteristic of the American perspective, especially that of the white man, has always been the exploration of the border. In the Western, this border is clearly defined as the frontier. But for movies like Bonnie and Clyde, which takes place decades after the Wild West was no longer wild, the desire to explore is left unfulfilled. Thus, the common post-war man found himself in a perpetually restless state. In this film, Clyde's impotence serves as a manifestation of the lack of purpose men felt at this period in time. Moreover, his impotence directly contrasts with Bonnie's overt sexuality, which directly parallels the increase in autonomy women experienced after the war. The roles Bonnie and Clyde fill reveal a key difference between the Western and the road movie. In the traditional Western, and even in the contemporary Westerns of the late 60s, the role of men and women is drastically different from the roles Bonnie and Clyde assume. If the road movie reflects the then current sentiments of men and women post-World War II, the Western serves as more of a form of escapism or fantasy for the male viewer. Generally, the cowboy is viewed as a typically rugged, independent man with an extraordinarily high level of self-efficacy. While this may be what the average man in 1960s America aspired to be, Clyde serves as a far more accurate representation. His main goal in life is to achieve notoriety and establish himself as an authoritative figure with control over his own life. But a conversation between him and Bonnie one night...
What'd you do if... Oh, so some miracle happened. And we could walk out of here tomorrow morning and start all over again clean, with no record, with nobody after us. Huh?
Well, I guess I'd do it all different. First off, I wouldn't live in the same state where we pull our jobs. I mean, we'd live in another state, and we'd stay clean there, and then when we wanted to take a bank, we'd go into the other state.
As well as his ultimate death, served to illustrate the naivete of his aspirations. In the end, Clyde is an admittedly charming man who attempts to assert control over his own destiny, but who ultimately proves to have a rather unrealistic, self-centered view of the world. It is not surprising that a historical event as monumental as World War II affected cinema, both in its application of pre-existing genres as well as its creation of new ones. But I believe that through films like Bonnie and Clyde, it is clear that the genres of the Western and the road movie are very closely linked. Their focus on the journey, among many other common elements, situate them both as generic cousins, or perhaps a father-son metaphor like the one Watson employs is more apt. While the Western appeals more generally to the male desire of self-sufficiency and independence, the road movie rejects its father's egotistical perspective and instead depicts the uncertainty and irrational restlessness of the post-war male. It constructs this rebuttal by both relocating the uncertainty within the narrative, as well as creating characters that augment female efficacy and undermine male competency. Furthermore, while the road movie provides its audiences with the thrill and excitement of the freedom the open road appears to offer, it also makes sure to highlight the frivolity of the pursuit of freedom of the road, illustrating the anxiety and loss of hope common in post-war American mentality. Through this altered representation of the journey frequently found at the center of most Westerns, road movies like Bonnie and Clyde are able to manipulate the standard motifs of the Western to yield a more accurate representation of the post-war perspective in the United States.